counting double-digit thousands.
Hey there, Dice here. So, I actually made a boo-boo at the end of the last episode. When I went to save and exit my game, I was used to the little symbol for settings being down here, and I just kind of came down here and clicked, and I accidentally started a new day, and we didn't even get do anything. No one got to move, so everyone's been in the exact same spot, but they've gotten a day older. Everyone's still here, though. We still have Von Von. We've got Ray Rala, Adam, and Eve, and then the new baby that we were gonna check out once we got back in. So let's take a look. This is our first horned male. He has the panda gene as well. Looks a lot like his sister Ray Rala, but his name is Kuvan. And we're gonna take a quick peek here at his genes. So he does have that ram horn, but it looks like he also carries antlers, which I prefer the antlers if I can get that in, although either one of them's fine. Medium ears, of course. He does have that big nose, and he carries his dad's poison fang. So that's good to carry that on. Now, he also has the spike body. Everyone's been getting the spike body from Eve, it seems. That has been a very dominant gene to go through the family, which, you know, I guess it's okay. It doesn't really have any negatives to it. It adds to strength, so that's really good. I like when they're strong. So it's actually better than the big body, which is what I typically breed in, but we'll take it. We'll take the spiky body. He's got nimble fingers and a runner leg. I'd rather him have a nimble finger and a claw, but this is quite all right. I'll take this over no paw any day. He's got two normal hind legs here. He doesn't carry webbed. He is short-sighted, though, so that's kind of the downfall. I don't think... Oh, his brother was short-sighted as well. Okay. Now, he does have that fishing tail. He got that from his dad. He carries his mom's stinky tail, though. She carried that gene, I believe. Yes. Let's see. His colors. He's double panda gene. He is blue eyes and carries purple. So, just like everyone else here, he's blue-eyed. A blue-eyed chocolate panda. he does not carry albinism or melanism. He has normal blood clotting, and his genes are A and G, or as I like to look at them, circle and cross. So he's actually really, really good. The only downfall, it looks like, is his short-sightedness, but we'll just have Kuvan hang close to his sister. I think his sister's going to take a liking to him since he looks so much like her. So yeah, we'll just have him stay close to his sister. Now, we need to get Mom out of the nest so he can grow up and move on to do his own thing. We're going to take a look here real quick, see if there's anything good we can go for. All we hear is a little gopher. Now, there's a lot of berry bushes nearby. I think we want to just head up one spot and probably put a nest down here. We might have discussed that before. So that's what we'll go ahead and do. We'll just have Mom hop right up here, and we'll get a third. Actually, hold on. No, we do already have two nests, so we didn't even have enough nesting material for it. So let's just get this little baby out of the nest. We can move him up here to collect these berries. What are his paws? He has a no paw and a runner leg. We would be better off getting this little baby up there as soon as he's old enough. So we'll move Von Von. Let's see, we'll move Von Von down here to help Adam with this berry bush. That sounds like a good idea. And we'll just have Mom hop over into the nest here. And Eve, I need you to get pregnant again. Perfect. We'll have Adam just pick that berry bush, have the baby pick the berry bush. And then Eve can grab all the berries that it'll let her grab. Ray Rala, grab these for us. You're pretty good at that as well. And so everyone has moved. I'm going to go ahead and skip to the next day. All right, so now little Kuvan is ready to move out of the nest. So, as I said, I think the sister would take quite the liking to him since they are so similar. So she's gonna want to keep him really close to her. Oh yeah, they're almost identical. So we're gonna have him just pop out here for now, and then maybe we can move him up here to help her with this berry bush. But we do have another baby. And it looks like a little Von Von, but he's got horns. So let's take a look. They're all coming out this chocolate color. It's really nice. Let's see. So he does have the horns. He carries poison fang. He has spiky body. He just has a normal nose. He does have a claw, so he's gonna be a defender. So actually, we're gonna have this guy out here through the grass, and since the stripes are good for camouflaging in the grass, it'll be perfect for him to just kind of stay sneaking through the grass to help protect him. He has a fluffy tail. He does have webbed hind legs, but it doesn't really hurt us on land, so that's okay. Normal eyes, fluffy tail. Let's see the colors. He has stripes, blue eyes, carrying violet gene, just the same as everyone else. No albinism, no melanism, normal blood clotting, and he is a circle cross. So all in all, it's pretty good. We'll just have Eve hop back down here. Adam, give us an assist. Thank you. And then pick your berries, both of you. Almost got that bush clear. Thank you. And Eve, I'll have you go ahead and clear this bush. There you go. Now, Rayrala, that kind of took Rayrala's job, but we'll just have her peek in the grass here a little bit. And maybe she would move up here and wait for her little brother to follow her. So we'll do that for now. And we're good to go to a new day. Oh yes, we wanted rain. We need to make sure we're stacking up on these berry bushes, and it looks like our nest is in need of repair. So we're gonna have, I can't see you when it does that. We're gonna have little Vanunu. I didn't get your name yesterday. Vanunu. We're gonna have you. We're gonna have you defend this way, I think, because we'll have somebody else come up here for the berries. But we'll just have you move over here. You're our little defender. Let's take a quick sniff around too, see what's new in the area. Not much. We have a rabbit and some gophers. Okay. We do need to work on collecting more nesting material, though. That is something we need to work on. So we'll have to start clearing some grass. We definitely need to get the berries though, because I would like to move on to... we're not going to be able to repair it, are we? I would like to be able to move on to... there we go. To the other place. Oh, but I can't get her pregnant because Adam picked all the berries. Okay, we'll do it next turn. I'd like to move on to the next large island, the larger easy island over here. But I think I'll wait until we have a good amount of berries. And I might need to start paying attention to how often Adam and Eve are producing babies, or even their children, when their children start having children of their own. Because we want to increase our berry supply. So let's take a look at our new baby. It looks like a straight up panda. I don't know if it's because it's raining or what, but that looks like black and white. It is. It is black and white. Oh, that is so cute. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so our newest little baby here is Celias. And Celias has the horn, medium ears, does have big nose and carries poison fang, has spiky body, as with everyone else. So Adam is now the odd man out, it would seem. It looks like the from the comments I gotten before, the yellow ring is supposed to be the gene that is mutated in. And I'm not paying a whole lot of attention to this, but this kind of tells you all that stuff too. I need to clear those out. There we go. So this gene was mutated in because it would have been something else, but it did mutate. And this was a runner leg that it was going to have regardless. So it does have webbed hind legs, a lot like its brother over here, Vanunu. Vanunu. Let's see, but Celias does have normal sight, a fishing tail, carries the stinky tail, has that black and white panda fur, blue eyes with carrying the violet recessive, and that's pretty much it. Celias is a female. Just by the name, I thought it was a male. But she's got pink horns. So that's new. She's the only one in her family with the pink horns, and she's the only one that's a black and white panda. It looks like she has normal blood clotting, but she does carry her dad's hemophilia gene. So we have to watch out for that if she goes to breed. And then her immunity is B and F. So it looks like we're getting a good mixture of their genes and their offspring. So that's good. Let's go ahead and skip to the next day. All right, no carnivores. That's always good. Let's go ahead and take a quick look around. Okay, nothing seems to have changed. So, Eve did not have a baby because she did not mate with Adam that turn. So let's go ahead and get that out of the way. And then we'll have her spend her three turns clearing these berry bushes. There we go. And then little Celias we can move out of the nest. And she'll probably just hang over here with the other horned family. Oh, look, we have a friend. There's a little tiny friend that just showed up, a little baby. I think we need to adopt the baby. Okay, so let's have Rayrala go ahead and give her a sniff, give her a little bit of food. And there we go. So our new friend is Anna Isana. So Anna Isana doesn't have any horns. She's pretty average, actually, but that's not average in a bad way. Runner leg and claw, so she's going to be another defender. So we can leave her over here because we don't really have a defender over here. Let's see. What is this? Rayrala, banish this animal from your tribe. Animal is too young to banish others from the tribe. Only alpha animals can banish others from the tribe. So you'd have to change their rank. And then what did the other thing say? Only omega animals can be banished. I've made omegas and alphas and betas before. I haven't done it this time. Everyone's pretty good so far, but if I go through and I start giving them rank, that'll be something to keep in mind later. But we wouldn't banish you because you're perfect. Anyway, let's get back over to Anna Isana. She has regular hind leg. She has normal sight, but she carries that blind eyes. So we'll have to look out for that. She's really young. So she's going to be a great one to pair with one of our little the little boys here as they grow up together. She carries the spots, which is good in jungle biomes, which we haven't seen yet. And I don't think we'll see it when we move to the next island. I don't think that'll be until the third island, if we count this as the first one that we're on. But she does have green eyes, which is something different. And she carries blue, which everyone here has blue eyes except for Adam. She carries brown and red horn colors. She also carries albinism. So if that got into a baby, that would be neat to see. She is a hemophiliac, and it looks like she has immunity genes I and A. So we don't want to pair her with anyone that has A, but we want to get immunity gene I into some of the babies if we can. For now, she only has one move. Animal is too young to clear grass. Okay, I didn't know that was a thing. We'll just have her scoot out of the grass then, so we can keep an eye on her. And meanwhile, we'll have little Kuvan pick the rest of the berries here. And then Rayrala can clear this grass. There we go. So now we need to find a potential mate for Anna Isana. So let's see. I call it a T in a circle. Vanunu, I think, would have his eyes set on her. Definitely. Yes. So Vanunu and Anna Isana are going to be paired up. He's going to scoot closer and just act like he's picking that berry bush there. There we go. And then let's see. Adam can pick this berry bush some more. Oh, but you didn't leave Von Von any job. So Von Von's going to scoot over this way and pick up where his brother left off and just clear out some more grass because his brother clearly got distracted. He had a job over here with the berry bushes, but he took off anyway. And let's see. That's everyone's turns. Little Kuvan here doesn't have anything left he can do right now, so we'll go ahead and skip to the next day. All right, so we have a new baby. And this time it is a little gray male with the ram horns, Tavonro. And Tavonro also carries the antler gene, like one of his horned brothers did, I thought. There we go, it was Kuvan. So, let's see, takes after Kuvan a little bit, it looks like, although he has stripes. So he'll be another one that's good to hide in the grass. He also has spiky body like the rest of his family. He does have nimble fingers, so he'll be good for picking berries. We actually might want to get Vanunu out of the way here, Vanunu out of the way, to allow this little one, Tavonro, to get up there so he can handle all the berry bushes that are right there. So it looks like he carries webbed legs. Dominant is normal. He has normal eyes but carries short-sightedness. Eyes are the same as the rest of his family. Nothing weird there. Then he has triangle and cross. Okay. So we need to get Eve out of the nest. We'll have Adam mate with her. And then Adam can pick the berry bush again. And this time he left a couple berries for Von Von to take care of. So Von Von will do that and then clear away some more grass. Now, little Vanunu is probably going to sit here and make idle chat while he picks berries with our new friend Anna Isana. And she is now old enough to clear away some grass, so she'll do that. And she'll also pick berries with her new friend. We'll have Eve work on the rest of this berry bush. Looks like that'll be her last turn for this day. Celias can just clear some grass for now. Maybe venture out a little bit. And he found a berry bush. So let's go ahead and take a peek again at what's around us. Okay, nothing much has changed. We haven't spread out very far. We're staying really close together. We can probably have Kuvan hop over this way just to explore some more. Because he is really young. He's very curious. Rayrala's keeping a close eye on him. But he, let's see. Oh, he found a bunch of rabbits. So there's probably a rabbit den right over here. Actually, it's probably right where that one is because it looks like it's up in the air a little bit. So we'll keep that in mind as we get more little clawed babies, maybe. So we'll have Rayrala actually go with him because she wants to follow him and make sure that he's safe. And can we? Oh, we sure did. We got the mole. Good job, Rayrala. And then everyone has used all their turns on the day. So we'll skip to the next day. And look who's all grown up. looks exactly like his big sister. So Kuvan saw his sister kill a mole, so now he's interested in hunting. So he's going to step in here a bit, and look at that. There is a bunny sitting in a nest. And this can actually probably be, this can be Issa, or Anna Isana's nest over here. So we'll let them set that up as they get old enough. But for now, Kuvan is going to work on these bunnies. And let's see if Rayrala can get one as well. Look, the bunny looks very comfortable in the nest, not moving at all. And then grab up that food. And then Kuvan can grab the rest of the food on his neck on the next day. Silas can go ahead and pick some berries. We'll wait to clear the grass for when she has three moves or when there aren't so many berries left. And then let's see. We had another baby born. Now, Tavonro needs to move out of the nest, but he doesn't have anywhere to go right now. So we're actually going to have Adam. Nope, let's have Vanunu. Vanunu is going to scoot over this way. Still going to talk to his new friend, Anna Isiana, and pick some berries with her. And then this new baby, this is definitely new. Kirvankir has a beak. Now this is interesting. How did this not mutate into the baby, but neither of the parents had it? Is it just saying because I didn't have it here, will the yellow ring only show up to what I have here? But it was one of the new genes, so maybe that's what happened. Yeah, baby's born and a mutation. Yes, we are aware. So let's take a look at Kirvankir. He has the ram horns, but he carries antlers. He definitely has a beak. He is big-bodied, so he's a lot different from his family. He's very different from the rest of his family. The only thing he has in common with any of them is that his colors are exactly the same as Tavonro's. Other than that, he doesn't look a thing like anybody. He does have no paw. And everything else isn't too bad. Just the no paw and the duck beak. It's not so great. But this is probably going to get him an Omega status. And he'll be getting the orange gems once those come up, unfortunately. Not going to kick him out just because he has Omega. But he's not the best breeder that we're looking for. But we're going to go ahead now and get Tavonro out of the nest so Eve can hop over and mate with Adam. And then that's not what I meant to do. But it looks like it regrows, so that's okay. Eve's claws, quite dangerous. Okay, we'll just have Adam finish picking this berry bush, and then poor little Von Von, he didn't leave any for you. Well, you can come up here and run these two away from this bush, because they're taking forever to pick it. I think they're more interested in making googly eyes at each other. Let's see, and that's it for today, so we're gonna skip on. Alright, and it looks like Vanunu has fully grown, but Anna Isiana is still a little young, but they can start moving over to the nest now. I think Anna Isiana has taken the hint, and she's going to move to the nest and prepare herself to become a mother. And we'll just have little Kuvan pick up his meal here that he caught, and let's take a look and see if there's anything else to catch out here. There's some more berry bushes, but they might want to head over and get these moles. Rayrala would probably encourage him to keep hunting, so he's going to head over towards those moles. We'll just take a step that way. And he's going to hang out until he can catch them. And then Rayrala is going to follow suit, but she's going to stop right here. And then there's two nests here, so she'll uncover one. Oh, that's not two nests. That's the old mole's hole. Okay, so Ana Isiana is actually, she's just going to jump right in the nest. She can jump right there. And she found a berry bush, so she will uncover that while Venunu works his way over to help her out. And he'll just sit there and pick berries as he watches over her, as he's done since he has seen her, since he first saw her. Now, Celias can pick her berry bush. She's still not quite an adult. Adam needs to work on his berry bush a little bit as well. We're going to have Kirvank here just kind of move down here. He doesn't really fit in, and he's going to be banished towards the edge of the island. So maybe he can find some work down here at the shore. I mean, he's not banished, but he's kind of being pushed out from everyone else because he's so different. And then let's see. We have a new baby to check out. Little Taku. So Taku has ram horns like most of his family. He's got mom's big nose and spiky body. He does have nimble fingers and a runner leg. What are we trying to breed in here? The runner leg. Okay. Maybe now we should switch to the nimble fingers to make that more of a dominant thing. He has regular hind legs, but he carries webbed. He has normal eyesight. A fishing tail. He's got stripes, so like his other brothers over here, he'd be good in the grass. Nothing weird. He does have black eyes, though. He's the first one born with not blue eyes. So that's a little different, but he still looks very much like the rest of his family. And the black eyes he clearly got from Adam. So let's see. Everything else looks great. So that's Taku, and we'll have Eve go ahead and jump in this nest to allow Taku to grow up. Stop depending so much on his mom. And then Adam will have you work with Eve there to have another baby while Eve picks this berry bush. Actually, we could have used Eve's turn. Adam couldn't do much else anyway. His berry bush was clear. And then, let's see, Tavenro, we'll have you scoot up this way, maybe. And pick that berry bush. And then little Von Von, you can just start clearing out this grass, because we do need more nesting material. We'll want at least enough to make one nest before we leave for the new island, I think. And everyone's turns are done except for Eve, but she doesn't really have anything else to do. So, oh, wait a second. You've got the pink horns like your sister. Oh, little Taku's got the same color horns as Celias. So that's cute. So it's very clear that Taku's a part of the family. But we'll skip to the next day. And actually, this is where we're going to leave off. So we have another new baby to check out. And looks like he's got the ram horns and the blue eyes that the family is known for. And Ana Isana is now full grown, so she will be having her own brood very, very soon, probably on this day. Everyone looks to be in very good shape. I don't believe we've seen a carnivore yet, have we? I don't think so. And we've made one new friend, which is Ana Isana, who is amazing. So, we'll just leave off here. Thank you guys for checking out the episode, and I'll see you next time.